So that was successful. I killed Bit. And I got the gravity. And so now I'm going to go fight this guy. Because this guy, I need... I mean, one, I have his weakness already. So there's no problem to kill. And two, he's got like the best weapon of all the weapons in the game. So it's in my interest to go get it as soon as possible. And three, I totally need that weapon to unlock some other shit. So I didn't jump on that platform because I knew it would lead to an alternate path. This is one of the stages where you can go underground and go fight File. It's an alternate path that you don't need to take, but if you do take it, then you can kill him now and not have to fight him later. So it also affects the end of the game, which is cool. I'm not gonna do it yet. I'm gonna explain why later. Totally get my ass kicked because that fucking drill attack is worthless. But this ice attack is totally a boss. As long as you're kind of point blank. Alright, so I'll pull out the Ray Sparkler again. Maybe that'll do some damage. Alright, okay. So. I'm gonna ride this thing all the way to the top. Which, by the way, electrified spikes on the side. They're instant death, if you couldn't tell. Here we go, we got a life up. Gotta make sure not to die. That was close. That was almost a game over. And there we go. I'm gonna blast this guy. Blast this guy. There's fucking shit everywhere. Can't be dodging everything. Which, I'll be so glad. This stage is where the armor upgrade is. And considering that I don't have much life left yet, and everything in this game does way fucking ridiculous amounts of damage. This would be a very welcome addition. Cutting all the damage in half. I will actually stand a chance against most enemies. That's what happens when you charge up the gravity well. Which I don't know of any other spots in the game where that happens. And hell, all it really does in practical uses against enemies. It only works on, like, flying enemies, I think. So, one of the bosses is Blast Hornet. So, clearly, that's going to be his weakness. So, basically, the way this works is now I got this I got an armor upgrade, which, every time I get hit, I'm going to have, like, this weird fucking spherical barrier on me, which doesn't do anything. It just signifies that I got hit in the face, I guess. Man, X looks kind of weird without a helmet upgrade, and he has all the other shit. Come at me, bro! So now we're at the end stage of the game. Or the end stage of this stage. All these laser tripwires everywhere. Totally easy to dodge. There's an E-tank around here that I can't get. You're gonna find out why in a little while. Need to ride armor. Put all these guys. So many of these assholes. I hate them. It's like one of my least favorite enemies in this whole game. Most of the enemies in this game are my least favorite because I just hate them. It's just so hard. So hard, girl. So now. I think there's supposed to be one more wall. Most of the shit is impenetrable when they're doing attacks, which is fucking ridiculous. I'll slide on here because I don't know if there's a pit. Alright. I'm good. So now I'm gonna pull out the drills. I'm gonna wail in this catfish. See, he's a catfish, he's got feet and arms. But he's still a catfish. I don't know why they built him that way, because he seems fairly useless. He can, all he can do is just flounder about and hop, barely move. I guess he works well as a generator of sorts, hence the name Vault Catfish. I don't know what he's shooting. He's shooting like electrified maces at me or something, and apparently sparks. I don't know, because I never fought this guy long term, like the way he's, I guess he's supposed to be fought. I've always used the drill, because I've always had it by the time I got to him. Just drilling him up his ass. Stun locks him, he's like, oh, it hurts so bad. No, I can't believe you did it again. I'm gonna keep hopping in the same spot and hope you go away. I'm gonna call PETA. His giant ass throat. It's like the Steven Tyler of Mega Man X bosses. Almost used up all my drills on that asshole. Like a boss. So now I get this crazy ass attack. It's like, you know how all the Mega Man games, there would always be one guy who would give you a barrier type attack. It would just cover you and then it would disappear after you hit one weak ass bullet or something. It's like that, except 100 million times better than all of them combined. Because it's basically like, it's a barrier that kills anything, most usually in one shot. And it lasts, it doesn't disappear in one shot. It just lasts for a certain period of time. So you just have infinite death for a certain period of time. It's awesome. And when you charge the ability, it sends thunderous quakes, which apparently makes boulders fall out of the sky. Which is how I was able to grab that health up. But I'm not done yet, because now, keep going to the stage, because if you remember, there's another part in this stage exactly like it. So basically this weapon is totally awesome, and I'm probably going to be spamming it for most of the rest of the game, because of how awesome it is. And even if you're not that close to the guy, it has a little laser that shoot out, so it's kind of weird to hit with, but god damn it, is it effective. I mean, it's almost like playing a Zero, except you don't have to, you know, hit buttons and shit. So to be close to a guy. And has way better range. Let's do that just for the hell of it. I'm trying to conserve life. Maybe hopefully charge up some of my E-tanks. Or probably not come close to charging by the end of the game, because there's always something to hit you once. Charge this up. Set a trimmer. Boom. Other than that, it's not very effective outside of in actual combat, so it's just cool to look at and to unlock shit. So this is the only helmet upgrade in the history of Mega Man X that I remember that is actually useful. From now on, whenever I first initiate a stage, I'll be presented with a map layout of the stage, a grid. And it will highlight where all the hidden items are. Here's an example. This is the layout of the stage. It's pretty fucking long. Way longer than most other stages from previous Mega Man games. So, as you notice, nothing was highlighted because there are no more hidden items in this level. Every level has 3 hidden items. Every level has a life up. Every level has either a sub-tank, has 2 of either a sub-tank, an armor upgrade, an armor trip upgrade, or a ride armor alternate part, I guess, whatever you want to call it. So I'm on Blast Hornet stage. And I love this music. This music is so fucking hardcore. Most of the music in this game is pretty fucking hardcore. Which, you know, I thought, you know, compared to Mega Man X, I thought Mega Man X 2 was, like, really hardcore. Like, oh man, it can't get much more hardcore than this. And, in all fairness, like, Mega Man X 2 was kind of heavy on, like, really rapid-fire double bass, almost kind of like Iron Maiden-ish kind of shit, with the galloping beats. And Mega Man X 3 is more heavy than it is, you know, really hardcore and speed metal-ish. So, I don't know if I would talk about this, but remember I was talking about Mega Man X2 when they were building it. Capcom said, hey, we designed this chip that's really expensive, that lets you manipulate 3D polygons in real time, which for the SNES is incredible fucking technology. Well, we're going to put it in the game, and we're going to force you to use it as much as possible because we want to kind of make money back on our investment. We want to be able to advertise it. Well, it's in Mega Man X3, too, so they had to make a few enemies that were polygonal, like that little fucking starfish, paper mache, snowflake, whatever the fuck it was. And it's kind of gimmicky, but whatever. You deal with it because everything else is so fucking awesome. So, now, there's a little crack in the hole right there. I'm gonna get through it. I think I need to use the drill. Is that good enough? I don't know. Yep. Okay. And there's some holes in the walls there. Not really as important, because I'm just trying to find access to this hole right here. Maybe it's this one. Okay, it could be down here. Let's see. So down here, there's the riot armor, which you have to unlock, and then once you unlock it, you can unlock all of the other riot armors. You can use all of your upgrades you've been harvesting this entire time. So it's pretty cool. That's what you'd expect. It's got a fuck ton of life that you can actually see this time around. Couldn't see it in the other games. They just randomly explode after you took a few hits. I'm gonna ride this like a boss. Apparently there was a life down there. Just huge, empty, wide-open spaces for no reason. Apparently there's like... One time I played this game and there was a mini-boss there. I was like fighting a helicopter or something. I don't know what was going on. It was weird. So apparently that's why that big open space is there. This would be a mini-boss area for Bit and Byte, but too cowardly to show up, are they? Fuck you two. So now... I think I'm getting close to the end of the stage. I think I've collected all the items. I collected the life up. I collected the right armor. I don't know what the other item is. I think it might be a chip upgrade. Let's see. Falling blocks from the sky. Always intimidating. Basically just trying to kill all these guys before they kill me. So I don't want to get hit in the face with rockets. Oh, boss time. Time to pull up my gravity wells. Which I like using the charged up version of it sometimes. It's not as efficient. You will actually probably get hit by trying to do it. But it just looks so badass. Just slams his ass into the ground. Watch this. Oh, he's spazzing out. Body slam! He's not a fan. That's basically all that happens. Just spew out these fucking orbs of confusion. And they just totally wreck his day. He just spazzing in place. Paralyzed with fear. Completely powerless. He does like to shoot a lot of bees and shit at you, but they also get killed by, I'm gonna body slam to death. Oh, totally destroyed your thorax. And his legs are totally clipping through the ground. And that's why you have malfunctions. Like a boss. So now I can leave this horrific nightmare of an environment. Alright. So now I'm going to go back to Gravity Beetle stage because I need to get the life up at the opening part of the stage that apparently I could not access until I defeated Blast Hornet. Otherwise, there's a big barrier there. So I'm going to go get that real quick and then go on about my way. I'm not even going to bother the other thing because it's a chip upgrade. I'm not going to get them, like I said before. I'm going to get them later. And also, all these enemies have been replaced by easier versions of themselves. They don't have the cannons, they just have the missiles. Which is the most annoying part, so... It's not that helpful. But, it's something. And there we go. I'm getting the fuck out of here. Mission accomplished. Calling it a day. And I'm almost done. At least, it seems like I'm almost done. But I'm not really. I'm not even halfway through this fucking game. I'm gonna go back here, and I'm gonna go get the life up there. Because I couldn't get it until I had a riot armor. This game requires a lot of backtracking if you want to get everything. I can't think of a more efficient way. This is the most efficient way that I've come up with so far to get 100% completion and not backtrack a retarded amount of time, but or subject yourself to a ridiculous amount of difficulty. I'm doing these bosses in order that, you know, I can beat the optional bosses, so I can unlock the other bosses, and so I can get all of the items. If you can figure out easier suggestions in this, easier little altercations I can make to my path, then feel free to go for it, but this is the best I've come up with.